كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة فمن زحزح عن النار وأدخل الجنة فقد فاز وما الحياة الدنيا إلا متاع الغرور. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With his divine support, he made it for us. He extended our life because we have a course to run. You remember with me last Friday, we lived with some of the scars that is haunting us as a Muslim woman in this world. The minority with the truth in their mouth and their life, but with no power to protect that truth. And we are living with some of what the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told us will happen due to something we have done. The pain of death, that is the cry for every Muslim on earth now. So we live with some of the scars, and we want to live today with some of the scars. And I mean by that, many Muslims' life has been taken who really wanted to live. And many Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them back to make them check out from this dunya, to check in into the akhirah. I'm talking about our Mufti. But before we go to him, where we cannot go to him, I want to go to our sister Husneira, who has been in the hospital for 2 months now, and now in a very critical condition under the life support. Our thoughts and our prayers with her in her struggle, and to any other one who is in similar condition. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to heal our sick and forgive our dead. And then back to the Mufti to start with the ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a statement to everyone who have been born on earth when he said, "Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut." Every soul will taste of death. Every soul. And the only way to escape this result is to never have been born from the first place. But as long as we are born, at some point in life, we will be called back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Mufti ran his course, so Allah called him back. For him, the test is over. For us, it is just the beginning. Our Mufti made the sense of serving mankind give you strength and peace into your brave heart, the heart that you use to teach us Islam with its two dimensions. And what I mean by the two dimensions of Islam, the body of Islam and the soul of Islam, and everything that exists has these two dimensions. The frame and the soul. the flesh and blood and the soul. And the body of Islam is the information by authentic, authorized knowledge. We call it ilm. Information by authentic, authorized knowledge that Allah allows us to pass it on to other people. It has to be correct information, authentic, and you have to be authorized to pass it on. This is the body of Islam, which means nothing yet. But the soul of Islam is way. The person who is passing on this information, their life itself is a walking Islam, a living example. And to me, and Allah knows the best, the Sheikh AbdulAzeem, AbdulRahman, Afifi lived his life like that. We prayed that he will not go. We prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to spare his life for us as a symbol of unity. But that did not happen, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who permitted the womb of the Mufti's mother to pass his life out into this world. So he has a right to call him back in. And no soul dies without Allah's permission, the way the Quran said it. وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تَمُوتَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. No soul dies but by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah permitted him to go. And I will not say to die, because people like that, those people who live in Allah and they live for Allah, death cannot touch them, but they will taste it. That's what the Quran gave it this name. Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. Every soul will taste of death. But people who live their life like that, we should not break down in grief. We should celebrate the strength of a good life that Allah sent this way, to teach all of us some valuable lessons. To me, the Sheikh did that. Sheikh Mustafa Sarakibi, the secretary of the Imam's Council, who shared with us yesterday on our way to the graveyard. And he said the last 4 days, the Mufti was in coma. But Sheikh Mustafa used to visit him frequently, very close to him. And his last words before going into the coma to Sheikh Mustafa was, I have been serving the community for 20 years, but it seemed like 100 years to me. Sheikh Mustafa, I'm tired. That's what he said. He did a lot. He was selfless, and truly, if you put yourself in his shoe, you will know what he means. He's one of the people who brought into life the committee of arbitration between the marriage problems. And every week, this sheikh has to deal with so many cases and problems. And we know what we're talking about. That's what he said to Sheikh Mustafa. 20 years of serving the community selflessly felt like 100 years. And Sheikh Majid from South Africa also shared with us as we appointed this young man from South Africa to be the Muslim chaplain for the Australian Navy. And when he told the Mufti that he's leaving permanently to become the chaplain, the departed Mufti said to him, "Sheikh Majid, make us proud in your post as a Muslim chaplain in the Australian Navy. Make us, all of us as Australian Muslims, proud in that gap. It is a win that, if you know what that means, it is a responsibility that Allah will ask one man on behalf of a nation." The Sheikh, the normal death that has been written on all of us, he died that way. But going into his mosque yesterday to pray Zuhr and then pray on his janazah, and his body was put aside, and we look at the body, and he looked a giant. And a giant means the stars in the sky of the heaven, similar to the young man the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told the Sahaba about, when they thought Abdullah bin Mas'ud was a little man with his thin legs, and they laughed at him. Not out of mockery, but out of love. "You are so little, Abdullah bin Mas'ud." And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam told them, "Are you laughing from the thinness of his legs? One of his legs only weigh on the day of judgment heavier and greater than the mountain of Uhud." Don't look at people's size in this dunya and think that greatness comes out of that. Looking at the cancer, the way he ate the body of the Mufti and make him become small, he looked giant, because we all remember him in the history. And to me personally, I remember him as a man who memorized the entire Quran in the bus. His shape was in the village, and he has to leave the city every day to go to the village using the bus as a place to revise and memorize. So by the time he reached the village, he will read by heart the Quran to the Sheikh and then back. I view him like that. The young man who memorized the Quran in the bus. The man who used to calm all of us down in our imam's meeting, who was president for so long, and then Mufti. And one young man from this crowd told me, once we heard that he's dead, "Oh, brother imam, this man came to Australia 1 year before me. But look, before he died as a Mufti. But look at me. I think I'm not doing good enough in life. We came here together. He's as a Mufti, and what am I?" You imagine, Allah uses everybody in this life to do something for mankind. Serve the post where Allah put you. And we just be like the Sahaba. Every one of them was a star, serving the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their corner. He is gone, but he can never leave us. Many of the African societies, including mine, we divide human beings into three categories. Number one, those who are alive now on earth. Number two, the Sasha, we call them. Those who recently died, but we are still remembering them because of the shortness of time. They just died recently, and they are still in our memories. And the final one, the Zamanis. Those whose zaman or time can never wipe them out of the page of your heart. Never. They live as long we live, and we can call them into mind and create their likeness in us if we want. Make them idols, but we know. By idolizing those whom we honor, we do disservice to both to them and to ourselves. If we do that, we fail to recognize that we could go and do likewise. But when we make idols out of them, and we start to praise and praise and praise these idols, we never do what made them that great. Otherwise, we can do those people who we love, bring them into life through arts, images, and so on. As Islam said now. But as we know, successful students will never break down because their leader is gone. And that's why the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam reminded the Sahaba throughout his life, don't worship my personality. I'm not a holy man. I'm a man of mission. And the only way to value me, take my teaching and live it with your life. And we should never start to glorify persons and turn them into idols. And that's why when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam died, and the shock made Umar ibn al-Khattab forget that reality, and he could not believe that can happen. But when the chief of the students of Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam came from his farm, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him, and he went in and covered the Prophet's face, alayhi salatu wasalam, looked at him, kissed him, and said to him, you are beautiful, dead and alive. And then he went out to announce what the Prophet lived for. He lived to take us all the way to Allah and live us there. And he told us to worship Allah. So Abu Bakr said, man kana ya'budu Muhammadan, fa inna Muhammadan qad mat. If you used to worship Muhammad, your God is dead. If your Islam, your Salah, your Zakat, your complete submission to Allah, if it was for a person, that person is God, is gone. So your religion is over. وَمَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيُّ لَا يَمُوتِ. But anyone who was so sincere in learning from the Master, from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he never linked to himself, as many so-called scholars do today. In enslaving the public and showing them their own glory, I am this, I am that, names that are turning into semi-gods. I am the Mufti, I am the Mullah, I am the Maulana, and you cannot go to Allah and let through me. These are people who are enslaving others in the name of Allah. But the real ones, never. They never wanted recognition. So the Sheikh's life was not about having the big shot or being seen. He was a normal human being. He did not want anything. And good people practice their nature. When Musa alayhi salam ran away from Egypt all the way to Madian, there was no plan what he will do next. And then he saw two ladies struggling to get water for their animals. And Musa alayhi salam practiced his nature. These people need help, these two ladies, I will do that. He did not know that doing that simple nature will bring into his life a wife who will help him to accomplish a divine mission, to become a prophet, having someone like Safura beside him. But see what he did, he just helped them, and that good act created a destiny for him, linked him to the father of that girl, caused that father to become his father-in-law, and get his wife to become his supporter to accomplish his mission, the dawah. And when he married that woman, on the way back to Egypt, he had no plan. He was called again by Allah when he saw the light, the fire, in the holy valley. And when he went there, he was called, "Oh Musa, you are in the holy valley. Take off your shoes." He did not say to Musa, "You are holy, but the place you are standing on is holy because of the presence of Allah on it." Not Musa alayhi salam. He did not expect that. It happened. He was chosen as a prophet. And his mission was to go and tell Pharaoh to let his people go, to let the Israelis go, and remember the purpose of his life. I can't say much, but all I could say, we should not break down in grief. We should celebrate this, because if any one of us can die like that, we should. When we live, and everybody, and if you could be in the Faulkner graveyard yesterday, I have seen Muslims, policemen, officers, children, young people, elderly people. They all came there, and they say it is the second most crowded janaza since our Mufti Sheikh the first Mufti of Australia who died, Sheikh Fahmi, is the second crowded jama'a, and Sheikh Mufti AbdulAzeem. The crowd on earth may represent the crowd in the heaven. Because if believers come to your body when you are dead willingly, and they're talking to Allah on your behalf, rejoice. And that is the only benefit we can make while we can talk to each other. Let those people from their heart witness that we used to be good as long as we live together. This is the only benefit in our social life. And the Sheikh, inshallah, he got that. As a president for the Imam's Council, as a Mufti, his voice always was for unity. And he knew how to talk. And he knew why he was talking. And this is greatness. When you know what you are saying, and why you are saying it, and how to say it. Because many of us, we don't know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Fajr, and when I was reading Surah Al-Sajda this morning in the Fajr of Salah Al-Jum'ah, Fajr Salat Al-Jum'ah, Surah Al-Sajda, when Allah describing, "Alladhi ahsana kulla shay'in khalaqahu wa bada'a khalq al-insani min tin." Allah, who made good everything that He has created, He made it good. And He began the creation of man from a clay. And then made its offspring from the cement dispersed water. This means Adam was made from clay, but us from the male and female sexual discharge made me and you. And we keep on going. And He told them that a time will come when you will die and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you don't believe in that, wait for the visit of Malakul Maut. قُلْ يَتَوَفَّاكُمْ مَلَكُ الْمَوْتِ أَلَّذِي مُكِلَ بِكُمْ. Malakul Maut, the angel of death, will take your life because He was created over you, and that is His mission. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. And then you will be called back to meet your Lord. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use this musibah as a recovery tablet for us to remember to do the will of the Mufti, and his will is that we are to be united. And the only way to serve him and honor his janaza is to be united. He never say nonsense in his life, as many of you. You never say nonsense. Every word you say will not knock somebody down, but build them up. And these are the attitude of the men of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They talk to benefit. But I will share with you the good news that we shared yesterday also in the janaza. When Malik ibn Dinar, rahmatullahi alayhi, was one of the people at Hajj around the Kaaba, and he saw a lady holding on to the cover of the Kaaba and saying to Allah, "Oh Allah, I swear in your name, by your love to me, that you must forgive me now. I swear in your name, by your love to me, you must forgive me now." And Malik bin Dinar, as a scholar, went to ask her, "Sister, how do you know Allah loves you?" And the lady said to him, "You go away from me for now." And some people told her, "That is a big Sheikh, Malik bin Dinar." And she said, "That is Malik bin Dinar, and asking me this type of questions, he doesn't know what I'm saying." And Malik said, "We all learn. Explain." And she said, "Do you think Allah will allow me to come all the way to his house and allow me to go into his house and allow me to stand in his house and talk to him unless he loves me?" It means we learn from that. Are you still praying? Allah loves you. Are you still reading your Quran? Allah loves you. Do you feel guilty when you do something wrong? Allah loves you. This is a sign. But if I'm not praying, I'm not reading the book of the covenant, the condition of our existence on this earth, and eating Allah's food, drinking his water, breathing his air, but we ignore the conditions, the rules. If you don't read the Quran, we will never know why we live. We live for a different purpose. So the only way then to know why we live is to read the Quran. If we do so, we will make it, inshallah. But good people never die, as we always say. They're only chance residents, that is all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the Sheikh, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for our shortcoming and the hard time we make cause for him to solve our problem until he said, "I'm tired, I'd rather go." بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن الحكيم وجعلنا وإياكم من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Dear Muslim, to summarize, let us learn from the dying people and let us learn to live in our brothers when we are gone by being good people who they will witness for us. And let us prepare for death, because we are not sure to live, but we are sure to die. We should prepare for what we are sure for. Allahumma fi al-muslimin wal-muslimat wal-mu'minin wal-mu'minat al-ahya'i minhum wal-amwat birahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma ahsin khitamana wa akhrijna min ad-dunya muslimin. Allahumma shfi maridana wa arham mawtana birahmatika ya arhamar rahimin wa aqim as-salah.